questions about it, yes.
I've been thinking about this, and maybe I'm, maybe it's kind of silly to ask, but the ones that were brought through the portal, so many of them?
Yes.
Where did they go?
They were dispersed to all six habitable continents. Not to Antarctica, not to many trees down there, but they were dispersed. Yes?
We were asking questions today and nobody seemed to be able to answer. Do they migrate?
Some will migrate. If they're living in an area where it's predominantly deciduous trees and those trees lose their leaves and go dormant, then they're going to move to another area where they can get trees that they can get the energy from the sun. They love, you know, places with conifers, various pines and stuff, because these guys are operating year-round.
Do they move from the, like, the cold areas? Like,
that's usually where trees lose their leaves and go dormant.
That would make sense.
Yeah, so they would move to areas that still have trees that they could use. So, but a lot of them live in areas where they don't have to leave because trees are functional year-round.
There's a lot of pine trees, like in Pennsylvania, there's a lot of pine trees too.
Right.
They can live in the pines or whatever else.
Yep.
Blue spruces.
And they would be there year round. And
yeah.
What was interesting is after I moved away from Alaska, I didn't even know there were Bigfoot reported sightings up there near like Fairbanks, where it's like routinely 30, 40, 50 below zero. And I was thinking, how in the world could they survive up there? Well, I didn't know anything about them going into trees. And,
right.
But they could use those trees in theory year round. Even though they're smaller and, you know, scrawnier than trees in the Pacific Northwest or elsewhere. Any other questions?
Do they look similar across the
Xanue?
Yeah.
They will vary, just like humans vary around the planet, but we're all humans. So they will vary in appearance, but they're still all Xanue.
So like this.